In this video, I am going to explain architecture of Hive. Hive architecture generally contains these five components, out of which one component is connected to Hadoop framework. Let us discuss these components of Hive one by one. First of all is UI or user interface. Through this component, users submit their queries to the system. This is the component to which the users directly interacts. The Hive shell on which we type the commands and see results can be considered as a user interface. User interface can also be of three types. That is, we can submit a Hive query through three different ways. One is using Hive command line interface. Second is using Hive web interface. And third is using Thrift server. Thrift server means by using JDBC and ODBC connections of any applications with Hive. Next component is driver. This component receives the query from user interface. Main tasks of driver includes: first, driver fetch the required APIs needed for the query that are modeled on JDBC and ODBC interfaces. And the second main task is to convert the Hive query into its MapReduce program. As I told earlier, that all the Hive queries are internally converted into MapReduce programs. So driver converts the Hive queries into their MapReduce programs with a little help from compiler. Our next component is compiler. Compiler has a little role in converting the Hive query into MapReduce programs. Along with that, compiler also does the semantic analysis of the program and then eventually generates an execution plan with the help of Metastore. And Metastore is a small database which stores all the structure information of our tables, partitions, number of columns in the tables, columns data types, serializers, deserializers, etc. Every information is stored in this Metastore. By default, Hive uses built-in Derby SQL Server as Metastore, but in real-time projects, we don't use Derby because it provides single process storage. Means while using Derby, we can't run two simultaneous instances of Hive CLI. In real-time environment, we use MySQL or any other strong database as our Metastore, which allows multiple simultaneous instances of Hive CLI. Last comes our execution engine. This is the component which is connected with Hadoop framework. Execution engine executes the plan which was created by compiler. It will interact with the name node and resource manager to fetch the desired output data from the HDFS and will finally give back the results to the user. Okay, so after learning the working of every component, let's see one phase of query execution. Suppose I have this query, select max of price as maximum price from table 1. Let's fit this query into Hive architecture. This query is first being put by the user through user interface. Then comes our driver. It will fetch the required APIs for the query and then will convert this query into MapReduce program with the help of compiler. Then the compiler component comes. It will do semantic analysis of the program and finally creates an execution plan for the program. While creating the execution plan, it has to get help of Metastore because Metastore is a component which contains the structural information of table 1. Metastore will tell compiler that table 1 contains these many columns and also that column price has which data type. These all informations will be used by compiler to create the execution plan. Then this execution plan will be provided to execution engine. Execution engine will interact with name node and resource manager of Hadoop framework to look for table 1 in HDFS and tell them to perform the task of execution plan. That is to fetch the maximum price in price column. Once the job is completed by Hadoop, it reverts back with the results which are finally displayed to the user in user interface. So this was the flow, how a Hive query flows in its architecture. Guys, this was the basic theory part of Hive. From next lecture, we are going to open our Hive shell and learn every concept and command of Hive practically on Hive shell. Guys, basic big data Hive is not sufficient if you want to work in real-time projects or to crack the interviews, because
Basic Hive is just a trailer of what we actually use in real-time projects. In real-time, we use like variables of Hive, table properties, configuration and settings, advanced joins, query optimization, repair partition tables, and many more advanced concepts. You can click on the link given in the post description to learn a full course on ADVANCE Hive. This course is very unique and rare of its kind, and you won't find the commands and concepts anywhere online which are explained in this course. And more importantly, each concept is explained practically on Hive Shell. So see you on the other side. Thank you.